And I know I can tell you anything. You won't judge, you're just listening. Cause you're the best things ever happened to me. Cause my darling, you and I could take over the world, one step at a time, just you and I. And you're the only one who brings light just like the sun, one step at a time, just you and I.
Happy Monday. Welcome back to Morning Coffee. My name is Rick Alexander, and I host the Morning Coffee podcast, where we really talk about the art of being human and what that means, really. And the human experience, of course, is marked by polarity. So things are really bad or things are really good. And every once in a while, if we're lucky, things are just in the middle, right? And that's rare, honestly, because humans aren't great at being in the middle. I think contentment in itself is a bit of an art. And to balance that with growth is a very, very difficult thing, because as you grow, typically what happens is that you actually grow more cynical. And that's just because the veil of life ends up getting pulled off of you. So it's like you can look back at your life at all these different seasons, right, where some were good and some were bad. But the ones that were bad, typically the reason that seasons become bad in our lives is because in some way we had a picture of reality and then the veil gets pulled up in some way. And people say that ignorance is bliss. You can look back at those times, you know, where you didn't realize certain things and it was bliss to a certain degree. But at the same time, you're making all these decisions in your ignorance, which are actually harming your life. So it's actually just, it's not necessarily bliss as much as it's just delayed pain, because a lot of times when we're not aware, let's say, of our shadow personalities or the shadow aspects of our personality, and they end up coming out in our lives, we go around and we're like going from drama to drama to drama. And it's like, is ignorance bliss in that case, or is life actually just handing you the same lesson over and over, which you're not picking up? Perhaps if you weren't so ignorant, the bliss would be on the other side of that lesson. And that's often the case. But today I want to talk about that, because I think we have to acknowledge the cynicism that comes with an expansion of knowledge, right? Because I remember growing up, one of the things I remember, actually, I grew up in a very, let's say, dogmatically religious home. And I remember actually being told not to question things so much. Like, I remember like having my curiosity really stifled, which is a very interesting thing to contend with, because of course I'm naturally curious. It's not like something that I aspired to. It's just something that I had innate within me. And as I've gotten into psychology and research, you learn that curiosity and imagination is really how you bridge your worlds together, right? The world of what is and the world of what could be is all bridged together by imagination, right? It's got to be that way. So stifling it actually has some pretty dramatically terrible effects long term down the road. But be that as it may, one of the things that's really interesting to me is I found that as I sort of left that environment and as I started questioning things more on my own and being like, well, this doesn't make sense to me and this, and then what about this, and then what about this? And I could do that forever because, again, I'm so innately curious. I'm just trying to figure things out. And one of the things that happened in that time is my 20s were really difficult. And the reason they were really difficult is because as I pulled the veil up on my worldview and as I started to have things in my life that didn't make so much sense for me, the problem that I then had to contend with is the fact that your life doesn't actually make that much more sense to you. And so knowledge is power to a degree, but it can be debilitating while you're sitting there with the broken pieces of a worldview. Or if it's not debilitating, it can also just be a bit of a drag, right? So like one of the things that's interesting is in the military, you get exposed to all of these different cultures and a bunch of things become really obvious to you when that happens. Like one of the things that becomes obvious to you is like how entitled people are in Western culture, yourself included. So there's a cynicism that brings. And then something else you get exposed to is the fact that the world is just really fucking brutal sometimes, like really just painfully brutal. And often what happens is when people are faced with something that's really brutal, like, I mean, just really tough to be faced with, they simplify their worldview or they grow cynical in light of what they've seen. And it's like, how could you not, right? It's like, fair enough, when you look around at the world and you see the more knowledge you gain about the way that things are, the more like all of the puzzle pieces don't make sense, the more you look around at people sort of going through the motions and you're like, wait, what? why aren't more people questioning it, right? Like, that's the first thing that happened to me as I started having this awakening in my late 20s. I'm like, how could I possibly be the only one that's questioning? This is fucking crazy. People are, we're killing ourselves in droves right now, right? Like, as a society, the suicide rate's out of control. Like, people are taking the off-ramp at a really heightened rate, right? And it's like, how come nobody's asking why that is? Why are we putting ourselves in the same mold, the same model that's not working? There's a great deal of cynicism that can come from opening your eyes to the world as it is. But one thing that I would submit to you is that happiness is really the art of learning to live with the consequences of what you find out. And I think that the easiest thing that you could do based on what you find out is to grow cynical. Like, it's the first natural reaction. It's not that that's a problem, right? It's not that that's like not warranted in some way, because I catch myself growing very cynical about the world. And in my late 20s, it was real bad. After like 4 deployments, like, I just found myself growing really, really cynical. And then again, that's fair enough. But then the thing you have to ask yourself is like, do you want to live that way? Because you got to live some way. And evolution doesn't go backwards. So you don't get to put the veil back down. You don't get to close the blinds. And so it's like, well, then what's the option? In part, the option is you keep going. That's why I did that one episode on being half grown. It's like, you can't just half grow, because that knowledge will just eat you alive. You got to keep going. You got to figure it all together. And then at the other point, you got to kind of make the choice that you want to. And that's something that I want to talk about today, is like, sort of the antidote to cynicism is deciding that you actually do want to be happy, right? Because if you decide you can't be happy, then you've already screwed yourself, right? And whatever your picture of the world in it is, it's just based on the world that you've been through, right? That's why I can't give you life advice for what you should actually do, because you and I live in different worlds. Like, our worlds are mostly affected. They're affected by a lot of things, but they're mostly affected by what we've gone through, okay? So we have a certain picture of the world, whether it's tilted toward malevolence and despair, whether it's tilted toward prosperity. That's based on the things that you've seen and the things that you've gone through. But you have to actually decide that you do want to be happy based on what you've known, because I just think it would be irresponsible not to address the cynicism that comes with waking up in life. Like, there's quite a bit. Like, you realize that things are not the way that they could be, right? And so you have to actually do two things. Again, one is you keep going. You just always keep going. You continue to gain more knowledge, because eventually you're going to figure out that you can put those pieces back together in a much different and better way. But then the second thing that you absolutely have to do is actually decide that you want to change, actually decide that you want more contentment, actually decide that you want to be happy. You know, I totally understand the pressure or the feeling to say, look, I can't be, because the world is this way, or because this, this, and this thing, right? And that's fair enough, but just understand that if you decide that you can't be, then you've decided that you're handing your power over to the world for the rest of your life, and you're living, so you got to be here in some way, right? And again, knowledge doesn't go backwards. So I just think the fight between cynicism and happiness on the journey of growth should really be talked about, because cynicism is the byproduct of knowledge, oftentimes about the world, right? But then happiness is the art of learning to live with the consequences of what you know, of what you find out. Because as you grow, you find that the rules change, right? The rules in life change. It's one of the things that I noticed after my first really enlightening awakening experience. I was not yet out of the military, and so I had this period of a few months where it was like, damn, the rules for me have changed completely. All my external rules haven't necessarily changed, right? I'm still in this same power structure, even if it doesn't align with my value system anymore. So happiness is the art of being able to do that, right? So you have to figure that out. And again, we don't live in absolutes. We live very nuanced lives, because humans are so nuanced and we're so paradoxical. Like, the nature of our being is so paradoxical. We can hold multiple viewpoints at one time. We can hold multiple feelings at one time. And so the thing to understand is to look through your own life, your own growth, and ask yourself, where has what you've seen actually caused you to grow cynical? And then ask yourself, are you going to make the choice to allow that to continue to be the thing? Or do you want to lean into happiness? Do you want to figure out the art of learning how to balance these things? And I almost think that's your responsibility. Otherwise, the knowledge will just, it'll spit you out. It'll just eat you up and spit you out, right? And you won't be useful to yourself or to other people or to your family. And there's nobody in the world that doesn't want to be useful. Just scan your belief system for where more knowledge has allowed you to grow cynical. And then ask yourself, might there be a different way, right? Cynicism is one way that you could deal with this, right? You could just close yourself off to it. That's totally acceptable, and you could do that. The other thing you could do is figure out what else might be true. What else is true about that scenario? There's multiple perspectives on every scenario, I guarantee it, right? And if the one that you have isn't working for you, all that means is that you have to continue searching for another one. I think your perspective is everything. And quite honestly, you know, I could lay out a really good case for the fact that what happens in your life is not that important. How you feel about what happens in your life is everything. It's far more important than what actually happens. What actually is happening is meaning very little, but your relationship to what's happening, the way that you feel about the things that are happening in your life, that's everything, right? And so don't allow yourself to grow cynical. Sometimes we do, and sometimes years go by, and that becomes our character. But there's other ways to live, and those ways are available to you. But you'll close them off if you don't believe that, right? It's you believing that is the thing that makes that true. And so I would just encourage you to stay on that journey. But if you stick with me, I'll stay on that journey. Anyway, I love you guys. I hope you have an amazing Monday. We'll talk tomorrow on Morning Coffee.
Do you remember the look on my face as I walked through the door? You said your parents are gone from the States. We were here all alone. So we bowled up in the kitchen with the radio on. Playing Clapton as we put paper towels on the fire alarm. And all at once you started breaking down, down, down. Crying, saying, please don't leave me now. I know that you're so afraid and it's getting late, but I'll stay till you come down. So close, but you're miles away. Till you come down. I watched as the light left the room. I started talking it down. Just breathe for a moment or two. We can figure this out. But you said you needed silence, so I don't make a sound. And all at once you started breaking down. Down, down, crying, saying, please don't leave me now. I know that you're so afraid and it's getting late, but I'll stay till you come down. So close, but you're miles away. It'll be okay, cause I'll stay till you come down. And I know it feels like it never ends. And I know the fear that you're up against. And I know that you're so afraid. Started breaking down, down, down. Crying, saying, please don't leave me now. I know that you're so afraid and it's getting late, but I'll stay till you come down. So close, but you're miles away. It'll be okay, cause I'll stay till you come down. And I know it feels like it never ends. And I know you're so afraid and it's getting late, but I'll stay till you come down.